Yeah, didn't we?
Actually, very interesting that you wrote the signature tune for that as well.
Yes, I did. I wrote it a long time ago, and I'm lucky to get Bud Flanagan, the great Bud Flanagan, to sing it. And we recorded it at the old Riverside Studios. It's 30 years ago now. And we said goodbye, and I saw him go up the corridor, and a couple of months later, he died. A great music hall legend, the great...
And just a very distinctive voice. Yes. Actually, how important do you feel it is in order to set the tone for any series or programme to have the right sig tune?
Oh, absolutely vital.
Yeah.
Because when you turn on the television, I'm not outshining you.
Not a bit.
Just speak up.
When you turn on the television
and the show starts...
More comfortable this than...
and the show starts, if you have the right signature tune, and this is another thing, Gloria, the right titles, people know exactly within 30 seconds what it's about.
So, no, see, right. Bill was nodding furiously when I mentioned the sig tunes. You obviously liked the tune as well, Bill, do you?
Well, I think it was part of the success of Dad's Army. No doubt about it. I mean, when you hear that tune, you are back in the 1940s, although Jimmy wrote it in 1968. That's the extraordinary thing. But, I mean, this is no secret, that Bud was recorded a lot of songs in the 1940s. Things like Siegfried Lion and Run, Rabbit, Run, and things like that. And it's very much like it, like those tunes that Bud used to sing. And so, therefore... We were back in the 1940s, before the programme started.
Just a minute. Are you accusing me of plagiarism?
Yes.
Well, perhaps just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
I never had an original idea.
Actually, but what I find extraordinary about the series, apart from it's, you know, it's wonderful that it's had so much popularity for so long, is the fact that you finished making it in 1977.
77, yes.
And yet the reruns have been endless. So why do you think it's just been so successful?
Well, you tell the viewers first, and I'll tell them second.
Well,
because I don't want to overdo.
I mean, we had the 1940s, we had a Home Guard, so therefore it's sort of loosely based on a part of our history. Well, it's not loosely based; it is based on it, and so therefore. People will look back in 100 years' time and say, do you want to know about the Second World War? And they'll put on an episode of Dad's Army. I'm certain of it, because it really takes you straight back there into those war years. And so the basis of it, the foundation of it, is a very good one.
Can I tell you a little story about Arthur? I always used to take him to filming. When we were staying at the Bell Hotel in Thetford, I used to drive him to the filming because David Croft, my partner, was there setting up all the filming. And I had to wait for Arthur. And he was always late. And he'd come up out of the building, buckling up his belt and saying, you know, James, these early mornings play hell with my lavatorial arrangements. So I said, well, Arthur... Why don't you... This is a terrible advert. So why don't you try bran? Because, you know, roughage. And it was... This is 30 years ago. People didn't go in for it. He said, I wouldn't eat that muck. It's like mattress stuffing. Anyhow, I got him a packet of bran. And he had it within 3 days. He used to come skipping out of that hotel. He said, you know, eating that has changed my whole life.
Wonderful character. But you see, when I watch any of the programmes, the camaraderie really comes over, not just as characters, but one imagines that you had great fun making the series as well.
Well, yes, I mean, we were like a family when we went away filming. No responsibility of telephones ringing at home and letters to answer, anything like that. We became a family up there for over 9 years, and so it was great. And I think also one couldn't have got into the person you were actually playing with unless you'd got to know them very well indeed. I mean, I loved Arthur, and the sense of humour was wonderful.
Bill was wonderful, Gloria, because I know distance lends enchantment, but there could be a lot of very awkward people, because they're all tough old pros, and their one hope was to try and separate David Croft and I so they could get in there. And Bill was marvellous, because when they got... Very, I could get a bit heavy at Bill always cheered them up with jokes. I've always been, I owe him a lot because he was great. I said, I'm going home, Bill. I've had enough of this crowd. I used to get furious. They won't learn their lines. They don't know how to handle their props. They show no interest, no enthusiasm. This is my show. It's one. And I used to get worked up. And I don't want to see them again. I used to walk out of the studio. Bill, said, no, don't worry, Jim. Yeah, he said, I'll sort them out. But he was always super.
Well, they all had their own little eccentricities, and that made them what they were. I think to mould them into a team as they were, one had to be patient. Well, that's fine. I mean, you know, one's got to be patient sometimes. Jim can be impatient because he's very enthusiastic and he wants to. But sometimes you have to be a little.
But the proof is, of course, the fact that it is still so popular today, even amongst young people, which also proves that the war provided a great backdrop for a lot of material. I mean, so much so that you've just, I gather, had success with a brand new series, just had a new one accepted again about the war.
Well, Gloria, it hasn't even started yet. I'm just wondering if I'll live to see it start. It's called Women with Wings, and I've always been interested in the part that women played in the war, where they're actually in the front line. Nobody's written about this, and this is about the women pilots for the ATA, Auxiliary Air Transport, who delivered these planes, and it's an all-woman cast. And I hope it's going to work. I don't know, it's a drama series, it's not a comedy series at all. But I just saw it as a tribute to the women. And Amy Johnson, the famous flyer, she was killed. She came down and they flew without instruments because the planes hadn't got any instruments. And a wonderful bunch of brave women, beyond me, why nobody's picked it up.
Well, it's going to be a great series, obviously. Well, just one final word about this series itself. And why it's been so successful, because at the very beginning it wasn't actually that well received, was it?
Oh, no. I've got write-ups. It's full of jokes and this rather little pathetic comedy. Oh, they were going for us. I think that was the Daily Express. I think the critic is long dead and gone. But if he's still...
Well, I thought in that first day of rehearsal, which was in a pub,
yes,
at Chiswick.
Yes.
But I'd never met Jim before, and I only had a couple of lines in the first episode, and I sat down and watched these fellas, and I thought, I don't know, there's something sparking here that I really felt that, you know, it was extraordinary. And when we both sort of met at lunch, and Jim obviously was nervous, it was the first thing he'd written for television, and he wanted it to be a success, naturally. And I said, Jim, I think this has really got something. I don't know what it is, but there's something there, and whether he took any notice, I don't know. But I really felt there was something there on that very first day.
Well, it just showed you what the critics knew, though, at that particular time.
We did the run-through on that very first pilot, and Arthur Lowe was all over the place. And David Croft said to me, because I'd cast Arthur, he said, Jimmy, I'm a bit worried. Arthur doesn't seem to know his lines. He said, I hope you haven't made a mistake. Now, Gloria, when you cast somebody in lead in a series, you hope he's going to be big. I never dreamt he was going to work. Suddenly, my blood turned cold. He said, I hope you haven't made a mistake.
Well, yeah, it was just one of the... I think he was at times a little bit, wayward with his lines, but that was, well... I mean, just when you watch Arthur work... I mean, I think he's just one of the most brilliant comedy actors.
Well, may I just say good luck with the book based on the series, and congratulations again on the length of time. It's been a huge success, so thank you both very much indeed for coming. And Jimmy Perry and Bill Pertwee.